Hey YouTube, this is a how-to guide on how to make a spear. That's what you don't want to do. Okay, so, you're going to need cardboard. Try to make it half a centimeter thick. You're also going to need... you're going to need a tip for the spear that's sharp. It's not that sharp right now because I've just been throwing it around. Four rubber bands. Doesn't matter what color. I have two different colors. Duct tape, whichever color suits you. Remember, these got to be hollow. Don't be like, oh, you're going to like the hollow at the end. Lots and lots of duct tape so this will hit something and stay on. I've made just ditches in the backyard. It will soar, if you guys are wondering. This thing will soar. And the reason you also have rubber bands, I'll tell you later. It will soar from, I want to say anywhere from 0 to 50 feet at the max, 50. And it hurts. I've got some bruises. I'm going, whoosh, and they'll bounce off you. So they're pretty fun to have a war, and you can also, they're about 3 feet long, and you can also have a sword fight. So, what you're going to first want to need to do, you're going to have one pipe, one cardboard tube. This is a halfway connection right here. I like to hold it right there to throw it too. Then you're going to need two cardboard things. The back's going to want to be a little longer. You're going to need one of the things the yarn is woven onto. It's a cone shape. Going to need wood. I'm using my hamster's wood that he's supposed to be chewing on, but he just died, so, not because he didn't chew on it, he just has something like 5 in his cage. Rubber bands are for where you want to hold it. Like, I don't like to hold it anywhere farther than these two rubber bands in that range somewhere, because if you throw it too far back, you're going to have to, like, from right here, you have to shoot it like that, and if you're throwing it like this, you're going to have to just, kind of go down a little bit, or it's just going to stay. It's a really good spear, actually. What I had a problem with is getting it to stay straight on there, but you'll have no problem. So what you're going to want to do, first thing is you're going to have this. You're going to duct tape it together. Duct tape this. What I did to make sure the duct tape stayed is I had put a wire through there, and I took the wire out once I got it. My duct tape stayed, so this will be exactly, because you need this exactly on the other one, like, perfect. So, one of just telling you right now, the finished product is going to look like this. Tip, you're going to need 3 things of duct tape. If you don't have 3 things of duct tape, I don't know what you did wrong. Or you just wanted to make a short spear like this. There's nothing wrong with that. I just like the longer spear. It won't be very wobbly, you'll see dust come up when it hits the ground. So, you're going to duct tape this piece, and this piece. You're going to, if you want, you can put some stuff in here so this doesn't come out the end when you're throwing it for some reason if you didn't duct tape it well enough. I recommend you didn't do that and have like a cut thing right there so it doesn't, the stuff you put there to stop it won't go down. It just stops it right there. It won't go back in if you duct tape it correctly. And then next, you're going to want to put this duct tape. Then you're going to want to put, well, first you're going to want to put this in, you're going to want to sharpen it. I'll give you a good view. Not very sharp, as I said earlier. And then, once you've assembled it, it's gonna just soar like a beauty. They hurt. If this it's sharp enough, it'll hurt, definitely. I've had questions on, other reviews. Does it hurt? Does it, what do you think? If you sharpen it, it's gonna hurt. Also, if you cannot get it to be perfectly straight, I'd recommend you throw it like this, where it's pointed down, not up, because when it's pointed down up, it's just going to hit and reject instead of sticking. I've had it stick into targets, I've had it rip through paper, it's very durable, you're going to want to duct tape it every few days. It depends on how much you use it. Every about 20 times you throw it, you're going to want to just check, see if the duct tape's still strong. And that's pretty much... and once again, I cannot put how much you're gonna want to put rubber bands on. It's very nice. The spear is definitely durable. I know I've said that about 100 times. It's great. I'm also going to be selling these if you want to contact me. I'm selling everything I do on this pretty much, except when I'll say I'm selling it. I'm also going to be making ninja stars on one of mine, metal ninja stars, so you can purchase those. They're not very durable, but they hurt very bad. Got cuts on my thumb. I don't know if you can see that. Right there. Kind of. This odds also done some cuts on my other hand. And pretty much good. It's really good. If you do want to buy one of these, they're like $5 per 10 per pack. So $5 per pack, which there's 10 in a pack. And it will be like these. And for an extra like $5, I'll make you like a thing where you can have all of them strapped around you, like a sling, and then the sling's attached to something, and you can just pull it out and be like a quiver kind of thing for arrows, but this is for these. If you want, you can tape the rubber bands down. I don't, because I sometimes, depending on how it's taped or retaped, I'll move them around. That's my review / making / definitely guide on how to make spears. So, bye.